our business, like in many other businesses, the key for us is getting people to pick up phone calls. I mean, we have to get attention to the work we do. And so I do things like I have an ad weekly in Northern Nevada Business Future, an ad in Homes and Land, and I do a weekly radio program. The whole idea is I want to get people to call me. So I'm always looking for new ways to do that. That's why I love working with Ron and Scott Morgan, because these guys are, you know, way ahead of me in technology, and they help me with new things. So about a month ago, Scott came to my office and showed me this QR code on his business card, and I didn't know what it was. And he explained it to me. We talked probably, what, 2-3 minutes about it, and that was enough. I went home that night, and I got online, and I Googled QR codes, and I learned about them, and within an hour, I had downloaded a reader to my phone for free, and I had gone to a QR generator, and I had generated my own QR code. And the neat thing about that was it allowed me to use that code to send people anything I wanted to. It could have been a message, it could have been I love you to my sweetheart, it could have been a link to a website, it could have been a link to a photo or a video. And so I chose to use my website. And the neat thing about the way it's done is you create this QR code, and it's like a picture. And all you have to do is drag it to your desktop on your computer. It just drags over as a JPEG, and then you can print it, or you can reduce it, enlarge it, and put it on your website, or send it to somebody so they can look at it. You can print it on letterhead or business cards. Anytime anybody sees that now, most people, probably 90% of people, don't know what it is. The 10% of the people that do know what it is, they're kind of impressed, because it's like a little club. And I think for a couple of years it's going to be like that. When people know what that is, you're at a whole different level. You're at a level of technology that they like. And, you know, I think there's really three groups out there that I market to. There's the 50-plus market, which is traditional media, and then there's the 30 to 50-plus market, which are kind of transitional. And then the 30 and under, they really like technology. It's really what turns them on. And those are a lot of my future customers. So I've hit a kind of a new demographic with the QR code that I didn't have before, because suddenly I'm out of the general box. And I tried something. I changed my photo on my Facebook profile, or my photo, to my QR code 30 days ago. And for the first week or so, nothing. And then I started getting a few messages and emails saying, wow, I dig your QR code. And then a guy from Philadelphia sends me an email and says, hey, I like your QR code. That got me to your website. And a few more came in, and next thing you know, I am doing an application with a guy who I believe, the trigger him to call me was he clicked on my QR code, and he's on my website, and he said, yeah, I've worked with this guy, and so he called me up, and we're rocking and rolling now. And, you know, when we do a mortgage, we make a fair amount of money on one mortgage, because it takes a long time. And that's the way the business is. So if you're in a business where even one extra hit can make you a fair amount of money, this is the way to go. And it's going to be hot for a couple of years. I like the fact that, as Ron said, Scott said, this QR code is like my signature. And if I decide that tomorrow I want to send them, instead of to my website, I want to send them to my video, I just go to my QR generator and I change where I want those links to go. And so now I have them going somewhere else. I don't have to reprint, I don't have to redesign. And I really think it's magical with what we're doing here. I think, like, for the next 2 years, we're going to evolve and become enhanced. And for those of us that are here today, you look at all these empty seats here. These people, for the most part, that aren't here, they don't know about QR codes. And you're going to have an advantage, like I believe I have, against my competitors because of the QR code. So I recommend that you use it. And I don't have it yet printed on my business cards, but I'm going to do that.
Well, it's easy to paste it right into your signature on your email.
Yeah, same thing there, right? Yeah. I'm going to be putting it into my print ads here real soon also, because you don't see this very often on print ads anymore. The one that you need to go. That's great that you're doing that, but if any of you are doing any marketing or advertising of any kind, I really recommend that you use the QR code. It's one more tool in your box for marketing, and if you want to reach that younger demographic, out there doing things, spending money, buying houses. Can't think of a better thing to do right now. Anybody have any questions for me about your codes and how I use it? Yes, no? I printed a big one and put it in my office. It's a great conversation when people come in. And again, when some of the realtors come in and talk to me, David Morris was in my office not long ago, and he saw the QR code. And, you know, it's like we became a little closer connected than we have been otherwise, because now we've got a common link.
It's like social media was 4 years ago. It's kind of the cool club. Yeah, you know, there's a certain kind of thing that goes on with it, you know.
Like a fax, you know.
When
the fax machine first came out, it was hot. It was a real good technology. And this is going to be hot, I think, for a couple of years.
And it's a good way, for example, with him being in the mortgage business, he can tell the people, tell the realtors, like, hey, I'll make a flyer for you. I'll make this QR code. No problem. Be happy to do it for you. So it's a way for him to generate business. So it's a good way to for B2B application, one business help another business, you know, kind of jumpstart their situation, you know. So it works out good. You know, it's great for bloggers, everything, you know. Really, it really ties in wonderfully, you know.
I like the fact that you can password protect it also. So I'm doing a little experimenting with sending certain documents with QR codes where only the person that has that password can scan it and actually read it, and so there's no... chance that the wrong person is going to get that. And I suspect at some point there could be a subscription fee involved with that. Getting the password, if you're selling something that you want to do in a newsletter or something like that, on a subscription rather, you can do it with that password and maybe make some money, you know, by doing it so you couldn't make otherwise. Saves a lot on postage and a lot of buttons that you could, no keyboard required with it, you are. That's what I like.
So you're saying that just like that, anybody can get, but you can also generate a password protection. Oh, great. That's the idea.
Yeah, and because you can send documents, photos, video, I'm going to use mine next to link people to my radio program, the past radio program. So if you want to listen to the shows, you don't have to go through the 4 or 5 different links. You just take a shot of that and it takes you right to the past program.
Now, so you found you're doing all your stuff for free, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And just to give you an idea how far this has come, just in the last year, it used to be $49 a code when I first started researching this per house and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like, okay, it's $49 unlimited, $39 unlimited, and then $19. And so the internet goes, eventually becomes free.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So now I always like to do my technology and do this group. And present to this group is what I call KIFS, keep it free and simple.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I'm always out looking for free stuff, so you're talking my language.
Yeah. And you know, in sales business, you want to have as much credibility as you can quickly. So I use it to help build relationships also. So it's easy to, if you want to build a relationship with somebody, you're talking about new technology that you'd like to share, and within 10 minutes, you know, you've taken them to a whole different area that they may never have gotten otherwise. And I guarantee they're always going to remember who it was that first showed them how to use QR codes.
You know, one thing to keep in mind, too, I don't know, maybe Scott mentioned it or even Peter, is you can scan this right through the computer, too, so that people can be online and go right through their computer.
Yeah.
Like Ben and I are working on a site that's just nothing but QR code.
Right.
So go to the site and it's just all QR code.
When I very first got my QR code generator and generated the code, I pulled it up on the screen. I pointed this at my screen to see if it really worked, and it did. It's amazing.
You can do it on a television as well. So
yeah.
If you were advertising your properties on one of the TV shows, you can leave that on there for a period of time while they're showing it, and you can download the whole tour to your phone.
Yeah. I also saw there were people that were painting a QR code as art. And it would read it. And then I also saw a cake decorated with the QR code. And the scanner would also read it. I'm thinking about doing bumper stickers. You know, nobody does bumper stickers anymore. You know, because...
Well, that'll run right into the back of you trying to focus in on...
Who is that up there? You take a shot.
Yeah.
And Depeche Mode, a band, has made a complete comeback using QR code. So what they do is they have the custom QR code in their video. It's really cool. It's all black and white. And then as the codes come up, you scan it, and then you're able to see the lyrics to the song. You can go and download a free song, you know, download all this stuff. It's really, really cool. So bands are starting to figure that stuff out now, and Depeche Mode is actually making a huge comeback kind of similar to how Justin Bieber made it on YouTube, Depeche Mode is now making this huge comeback using QR code. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, yeah, it's just amazing. You know, I'm the kind of person that lies at night thinking of the potential of stuff like this, and it's amazing when you think about it.
Yeah, I am also working with a guy that we're working on creating a set of GoBos. And GoBo is an aluminum, associative aluminum that you put over a light, and so when the light casts through, it throws out the pattern. You might have seen them in some Broadway plays and some theaters. And we're making one with QR code, so that you can like have a searchlight kind of point at a building, and your QR code goes up there. And like any searchlight, it draws attention, and so, what is that? Yeah. And if we just get one here,
cloudy night.
Will it be able to read the light, the shadows and stuff?
Well, that's what the goal is. It reads the light against the wall.
The light, you're talking about JPEG, a lot of times, depending on how it is, it could be distorted this way, even though you start with something square, is it important that it's square, or I'm guessing that it's not?
Well, it always generates a code that is essentially square.
Yeah, but give you an example. You take, let's say you have a TV broadcast in the 3x4 size, and you put it in the other one, which is 9x16, everything looks, to me, it looks hideous, and it would obviously, just with QR code, it would no longer be square, it would be a different shape. But I'm assuming it's supposed to be read somehow.
It can read it in a rather distorted manner.
Okay.
And what it does is, if it's having problems, it will scan. It'll throw out light diodes looking for specific patterns and then snap it. But if it's having difficulty, if it's distorted, it will actually scan it, just like the old-fashioned machines.
Okay.
And go right down every single piece of code until it can read the entire thing, and then it'll snap it. It can be fairly distorted.
Sometimes you have a photo, and let's say if you resize it or something
sure.
like that, it could come out to be...
Mm-hmm.
It could be a distorted thing unless you keep the aspect.
It's amazing how capable it is.
Yeah. This is how right there I got that. That's how the camera reads it. Okay, that's the technical specs on how the camera reads it right there.
And really, the QR code is really designed to get you from print or flat surface to electronic. So I think it's probably going to be rare that somebody would scan something on a video monitor. Well, it can do it, but the idea is that this is something you put on billboards, on walls, on signs, on paper, so that you don't have to take the paper with you or even punch any numbers. You just take a quick photo, and you essentially have all the data that is on that page, because you can put everything you want on that one scan.
Just by having the tree just identifies which side is up and other things like that.
And since you create the data, you create whatever you want in any language. If you want it, you can encode it in any way. And like I say, password protection is what I think is very cool, because I think there's money to be made with subscriptions doing this. Kind of like when 900 numbers first came out, people were using them for polls and all sorts of different things. You can pay a quarter to do something like that. I suspect some of these are going to be subscription. And if you have the right kind of information that people will be willing to pay for, this will be one way to generate that cash. Next time I come out, I'm going to tell you to redevelop that problem.
And by the way, it's not just little Reno, Nevada, where it appears we're behind the curve and like, oh my God, where's the stuff been? If you go on these Active Rain, which is a blogging platform for all the agents, there's very few agents that are adapting this. I mean, we're talking about maybe 3 or 4 dozen agents across the United States, David Morris being one of them here in this town. There's a few people down in the Bay Area. And again, the analogy I like to do is like it was like social media 4 years ago. There's a guy, Kirk Bailey, now, who's kind of out spreading the gospel. And he's filling the rooms with realtors down in the Bay Area and stuff. It's like, oh my God, QR code, we got to get on board. The realtors can't get enough of these things, and you're just going to start seeing these things everywhere, especially in real estate and mortgage broker.
I didn't even write down URL numbers or go to link, find, ask me for the links to where I did this. I just Googled QR reader, and Google took me to the five best readers for the kind of phone I had, and then 5 minutes and I was done with the reader. And then generator, same thing. I just typed in QR generator, and it says for this kind of phone, the iPhone, these are the top five, and this is the reason why each one is recommended. And then I picked the one that I wanted, and I get another 5 minutes. It's surprisingly fast. You don't have to be really technologically savvy to do this. You just have to push a few buttons. That's very cool. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Peter. Thanks, everybody, for showing up. I don't know if you guys, most of you guys know this, but we also have a real estate investors meeting at 6, so you know, feel free to stick around for that. And Leslie Henderson will be talking about short sales tonight. So thanks, and I know it's an odd time, so I appreciate everybody coming up, but we just kind of come in here in this room before the meeting. The room's paid for, so we just kind of have this informal group. And if anybody knows any presenters, or if you guys ever want to present yourself on technology stuff, you know, please let me know, because we're always looking for state-of-the-art stuff like this. So thanks a lot.